Hi all, today we are going to discuss about inductance of coaxial transmission line. So first let us take the case of hollow conductor. So I am taking the case of the hollow conductor. So let us take for example my transmission line is like this. So it is having a hollow conductor, that means inside nothing will be there, entire current will pass through the surface having a radius of a, and the outer conductor is at a distance of b from the center and having a very thin layer. Let us assume the layer is very thin or the thickness is very less, so that the calculation making will be easy. So this I can represent in the side view, the conductor will be like this, there is a hollow conductor and with respect to the center it is making a distance of a, and the current that is carried by this is in this direction or the positive current. And let us assume the second conductor or the outer conductor will be like this. Now this outer conductor cross sectional view is like this, it is carrying a current I in the opposite direction and it is making a distance of B from the center of the conductor. So now if you want to find what is the amount of the flux that is produced at a distance R from the center of the conductor. So let us assume I want to find at a distance R from the center of the conductor. So here I am just taking a differential radius dr and here I want to find my differential flux, how much is produced in this. So inside the hollow conductor we know that as per the ampere circuital law, the closed integration of h dot dl is equal to current enclosed. So if you are taking inside the conductor, let us take for example I am taking the conductor, it is a hollow conductor, right? So the current is only confined to the surface. If you are taking inside the hollow conductor, if you are taking the amperian loop, in this the let us assume the h, closed integration of h dot dl is equal to current enclosed, because here if you are taking inside the conductor this current enclosed is equal to 0, so automatically H will be equal to 0. So what I mean to tell, inside the inner hollow conductor the flux is equal to 0, so automatically flux linkages and everything becomes 0, we need not worry. So the flux will be only if the value is greater than or equal to A, so above the surface of the conductor only it will be there. So if you want to find the flux at a distance R from the center of a conductor, that can be given by B is equal to mu naught into I divided by 2 pi r, because h is equal to closed integration of h dot dl. Again same thing, like let us assume I want to find here, I am taking this as my amperian path. So let us assume I want to find at a distance of r. So this closed integration of, because h we are taking in the same path, closed integration of h dot dl, this will be equal to, let us assume at this point the value of h is equal to h multiplied by closed integration of dl, we are taking the circle, so this will be equal to 2 pi into r, that is the circumference of the circle, is equal to current enclosed. Current enclosed is the total current. So from this I can calculate h is equal to I divided by 2 pi r. So mu into h is called as the b, so I can tell that this is b is equal to mu into h, that means mu naught into I by 2 pi r. That is the reason why it came. I think it is clear to you. So now let us proceed further. So consider, I am considering the length is equal to 1 meter only. The length of the cable is equal to 1 meter to make the analysis easy. So now I want to know how much flux is crossing this small radius, differential radius dr, and the length is equal to 1 meter, because we know the direction of the flux. If you are taking the direction of current, take for example the current is coming away or away from your paper or coming towards us, you apply your right hand rule, your thumb indicates the direction of the current, the thumb is indicating towards us, then your curled finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. So direction of the magnetic field will be radial only, so the direction of magnetic field will be radial like this. If you apply, you will get your direction of magnetic field as like this. So that path I have to take. So I am taking the small differential area, so that area I am calculating. So I can calculate the flux crossing 1 dr, because the length is equal to 1 multiplied by dr, this will be equal to the flux density multiplied by the area. So flux density multiplied by area is equal to dr multiplied by 1, that is dr. This is nothing but the differential flux that is leaving. So this differential flux will be equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi r, that is the value of b, multiplied by differential radius is dr. So now I want to calculate the flux linkages. So flux linkages at a distance 1 up to some finite distance, let us assume I am calculating up to some finite distance. Yes, actually the flux extends up to infinite. Let us take for example I am taking the s, which is very huge value, much far greater than the radius. I am calculating up to there, which will approach to infinite if you want. So this I can write as integration from a to s this will be the value of d phi. That gives the total value of the flux linkages. So this I can write as mu naught I divided by 2 pi integration from A to S into 1 by r dr, because only r is the variable here. So if you are calculating this, this will become equal to mu naught I by 2 pi into ln of S divided by A. Let us take it as equation number 1. So this equation number 1, I am going to just change it like this, mu naught I by 2 pi ln of. So this I can change in some different form. This I can write as multiply and divide by B. I can write it as B by A multiplied by S by B. I can separate in this form. So how to separate this and what is the need, that we are going to see in the coming steps. So please remember up to here. So now the external or the outer conductor also produces the flux linkages. So that is from R is equal to B to some external, some point S. So the flux linkages produced due to current passing in the outer conductor. So that I can represent as integration from B to S, nothing but d phi. So this will be that current is equal to minus I. So it will be mu naught I divided by 2 pi. Remember here, this flux linkages is only if the outer conductor is existing. How much is the flux linkages? I am calculating only if inner conductor is existing, what is the flux linkages. So total flux linkages will be sum of these two. That is the reason I am writing like this. So mu naught I by 2 pi integration from B to some finite distance S into 1 by r dr. This is what we get. So this will be equal to minus mu naught I divided by 2 pi ln of S divided by B. Getting it? So now equation number 1, that whatever equation number 1, so equation number 1 can be written as mu naught I divided by 2 pi ln of B by A multiplied by S by B. I can separate into ln of A multiplied by B will be equal to ln of A plus ln of B. So that property I am using. So this will become mu naught I by 2 pi ln of S divided by B. You got in this form? Let us take it as equation number 3. So now I am, total flux linkages will be equal to flux linkages due to internal conductor plus flux linkages due to external conductor. So this will be equal to the sum of equation number 2 plus equation number 3. You can see this mu naught I by 2 pi ln of S by B is here, here also there, but sign is opposite. So automatically that will cancel out. We will get only mu naught I by 2 pi ln of B by A. You can see here, this is only giving the flux linkages due to current carried by inner conductor, that too from the surface of the inner conductor to surface of the external conductor. Only that much is giving. So what is happening to the remaining things? The reason is, if you are taking the conductors, I am taking again, this is carrying a current of, sorry, we are taking hollow conductor, right? So this is carrying a current of plus I, and this outer conductor is carrying a current of minus I. You agree with me? So now if you want to find the flux crossing any closure surface which is outside this. So outside this, I am taking the radius outside this one. So the closed integration of H dot dl is equal to the current enclosed. So this is H multiplied by 2 pi r. This will be equal to, what is the current enclosed? Current enclosed is inner conductor is carrying a current I, and the external current is conductor is carrying minus I. So sum of these currents, this will be equal to 0, or we can tell outside this conductor or outside this cable, the value of the magnetic field will become equal to 0, because both the currents are cancelling out. Getting it? So that is the reason that formula came. Directly you can write, or I have derived to prove it that it is coming in that form. So now we can calculate my value of inductance. Inductance is equal to flux linkages per unit current. So this will be flux linkages by current. This will be equal to mu naught divided by 2 pi into ln of B by A. This will be in Henry per meter. So let us take it as equation number 5. So this you can represent either in the form of ln, and sometimes if you are operating in power systems, we generally represent, because transmission line is in kilometers, it is represented in milli Henry per kilometer. So then we can represent this as 0.4606 log to the base 10 of B by A. This will be in milli Henry per kilometer. This is one of the ways. Either you can represent in above form, or you can represent in the lower form. Any one of these forms is used in practice. Okay. Now let us see the inductance of coaxial line with solid inner conductor. So I am taking the case with solid inner conductor. So solid inner conductor means the inner conductor also is a solid. So it is a solid, and there is a outer conductor. Getting it? So this can be represented like this. There is a conductor, inner conductor is there. So inner conductor is a solid conductor. So there is a conductor like this. It is having a radius of A, and there is one outer conductor at a radius of B. There is an outer conductor. Let us assume the thickness is negligible. This is carrying a current of I in opposite direction. This is carrying the current in the positive direction. So we have already derived previously the magnetic field produced by a coaxial cable. So there I have already discussed this. So I am directly writing the value of H. So the H, due to the inside the conductor, that means at any radius R less than A. So inside the solid inner conductor can be given by H dash is equal to I by 2 pi A square into R. This is what we have already derived. So if you have the doubt, you can please refer there, because if I am deriving again here, it will take 5-10 minutes. You can please refer to the magnetic field due to the coaxial transmission line. So there I have discussed this in detail, how this derivation came. So this I am taking as equation number 6. So from this, I can calculate the flux produced by the inner conductor, that is B dash, will be equal to mu I divided by 2 pi A square into R, where 0 less than or equal to R less than or equal to A. Let us take it as equation number 7. So similarly, the flux outside this radius will be mu naught I divided by 2 pi R. This also we have discussed there. So please refer there. This is for A less than or equal to R less than or equal to B. So I am just directly taking it. So now, again taking at a radius R. So if you want to calculate the differential flux will be equal to B multiplied by dr. Assuming the length will be equal to unity, that means per meter length. Okay. Now, the flux that is produced, so d phi, if you are substituting this formula, this will come as mu naught I into R divided by 2 pi A square. So, let us take the case inside conductor. So, inside conductor there will be internal flux linkages. Outside the conductor there will be external flux linkages. Because both formulas are different, we will derive them separately, then combine the total effect. So, I am deriving for the internal case mu naught I into R divided by 2 pi A square multiplied by dr. This is what we get. So, this value, so if you are taking this conductor, there is some conductor. So, inside this conductor, let us assume I am taking at a radius of R, that means up to this radius I want to calculate. So up to this radius, because if the total current is equal to I, the current I am assuming uniformly distributed, so current per unit area will be equal to I divided by, let us assume the radius of this conductor is equal to A, this will be equal to I divided by pi A square, and the total amount of the current that is enclosed up to radius R will be this current density multiplied by the area. So, this will be equal to pi r square, or otherwise the current that is enclosed up to this radius r will be equal to I multiplied by r square by a square times. The total current is not enclosed, only this much percentage of the current is enclosed. So, if you want to calculate the flux linkages, so differential flux linkages will be whatever the value of d phi is there, it is only multiplying with r square by a square times of the total current, only r square by a square times it is doing. So please remember this. So as you are going away, it is linking more because the radius is going on increasing. So now this I can write as mu naught, because sometimes the relative permeability of the material may be there. So mu r will be there if you are writing this. So this will be I r divided by 2 pi a square into r square divided by a square into dr. This is what we get. So this I can write as mu naught mu r into I into r cube divided by 2 pi a to the power of 4 into dr. This is what we get. So if I want to calculate the total flux linkages, this will, we have to do the integration of this one. Where you have to do the integration? Integration from 0 to surface of the solid conductor. So this will become integration from 0 to a, this mu naught mu r I divided by 2 pi a to the power of 4. All these are constant. Only variable is r cube into dr. So if you are substituting this, this will become mu naught mu r by 2 pi into a to the power of 4. This will become r to the power of 4 divided by 4. R to the power of 4 divided by 4 means it will become a to the power of 4 divided by 4 when you are substituting. So a to the power of 4 and 4 will cancel. So you will get your answer as mu naught mu r divided by 8 pi. Let us take it as equation number 9. So we got that the internal flux linkages, or the flux linkages due to the solid conductor up to the surface of the conductor, is mu naught mu r by 8 pi. This is what is obtained. So now between the conductor A That means up to the surface A, up to the B. This will be similar to the previous case. So, previous case we have already derived the flux linkages will be equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi into ln of B by A. I am directly taking this one. So, outside the complete conductor, so because here inside the current is equal to I, outside the conductor it is minus I. So, outside this value of B, this is B, this is A. If you are taking the radius outside B, because we know that the current enclosed will be equal to 0. So, automatically the H will be equal to 0 and flux linkages will be 0 outside the conductor. Okay, that is the reason I am not considering the remaining things. So, now the total flux linkages will be, value will be internal flux linkages plus external flux linkages, and inductance will be equal to total flux linkages divided by the current. The current is equal to I. So, this will become mu naught divided by 4 pi into, due to the internal flux linkages, internal flux linkages is mu naught mu r by 8 pi. So, that is what I am writing, mu r divided by 2 plus 2 times of ln of B by A. This is Henry's per meter. This is what we get. So, from this I can further simplify, mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7. This becomes 10 to the power of minus 7 into, so let us take 2 also outside, 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 into mu r divided by, because 2 I have taken out, so this should be multiplied by 4, so plus ln of B divided by A. This will be in Henry's per meter. So, this I can further simplify, this will become equal to 10 to the power of minus 7 into mu r divided by 2 plus 4.606 log to the base 10 of B by A into 10 to the power of 6 milli Henry per kilometer. I have just converted this to logarithmic form, or this will become equal to 0.05 times of mu r plus 0.4606 times of log to the base 10 of B by A. So, this will be in milli Henry per kilometer. So, generally in transmission line you will see this one. This is the value of L in logarithmic form. So, let us take the first one only, that natural logarithmic form or ln form, and we will continue. So, practically if you take any conductors, the conductors that are used are either copper or aluminium is used. Both these are non-magnetic materials. So, for them the value of mu r is equal to 1. So, whatever the equation that is obtained here, this equation I am taking as equation number 11. This equation number 11 can be represented in this form. L is equal to 10 to the power of minus 7, that means 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7, 1 by 4 plus, this will be ln of B divided by A. You agree with me? Let us take it as equation number 13. So, this I can further simplify. 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7, this 1 by 4 I can write as ln of e to the power of 1 by 4, ln of e, that will cancel, so 1 by 4 will come out, it will be same, ln of B divided by A. So, this I can write as 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7, this e to the power of 1 by 4 I can take here, B divided by A into e to the power of minus 1 by 4, when I take to denominator it become minus, so this I can write in this form. So, this if you further simplify, this will become 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln of B divided by e to the power of minus 1 by 4 will be 0.7788 times of A. This is the value of the inductance. So, this value is in Henry's per meter. Getting it? So, here this 0.7788 times of A I can replace by A dash. So, when I replace by A dash, let us take for example, then it will become 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln of B by A, this will be in Henry's per meter. You can see the case of this hollow conductor, hollow coaxial cable conductor, we got the similar equation ln of B by A. Here instead of A, I am keeping A dash here, that is the difference. So, from this I can tell that this A dash is nothing but 0.7788 times of A. Why A is multiplied by this 0.7788? Because of, in a solid conductor there will be internal flux linkages also. So, we can tell that if a solid conductor can be represented by its equivalent value of A dash, where A dash is equal to 0.7788 times of A. So, this indicates the fictitious conductor having a radius of A dash and a hollow conductor can produce the same value of the inductance as a solid conductor. Okay, so this is also called as geometric mean radius. So, this you are going to see in power systems. Getting it? So this L can be represented in terms of log form also. This will be equal to 0.4606 log of B by A dash. So in this form it will be represented. So this will be in milli Henry per kilometer. You can try to convert that L into log and convert in the form of milli Henry per kilometer. You will get the same answer. Please check it, because some people who are working in the electrical engineering in power systems, you will get this equation. I hope that how to calculate the inductance of coaxial transmission line is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.